Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and welcome. Look at me, look, I got to pick a pocket or two. Sorry, I've gone off already, you know. We've got a few beers down from our beautiful Cotsey and Boff shop. A lovely legend, and I've kind of feel a bit responsible for creating a monster, and very excited about it as well. Because if you follow my channel and everything else, you see that now and again, breweries send me down trial beers that have not actually been released, and they say, we want you to be our crash taste dummy and that with them, you know, you to try them out and see if you drop down. No, seriously though, you to try them out and see if, you know, what you think, and give us your kind of, your opinion of them and that. And it's lovely when people value my opinion and my palette and my bugle and everything else, you know, even if my presentation ain't always so lovely and all wine buff like, oh yes, and it smells of a vineyard in orchards and autumn and God knows what else. Sorry, I do digress. I've got the clock running here because I do, otherwise I get passionate, especially about good beers and that. And carry on and on and on, but I'm going to try to tell you why I get this beer out. Look at the packaging, look. Isn't that brilliant stuff? It's all proper blown up around it and all careful. But this is Jason Cotsey from Cotsey and Boffa. And it's got there on the back there a bit of details in it. I think I've created a monster with him, and I'm very pleased with it too. I am. He's a big wine buff and really knows his wines. Fantastic palate for wines, fantastic knowledge. His heart's, you know, heart's in the vineyard, and the soil of the vineyard is on his shoes, you know, that sort of thing. Really, really nice guy as well. Doesn't kind of thrust his knowledge in your face and everything else. You go to him, he helps you out, and he really looks after you. He's a really lovely fella. Can't kind of sing his praises enough, but he's kind of got the bug, you know. He enjoyed my reviews. He sent down a few wines for me to review, because I think he'd seen one of my wine reviews. I think I'd only done one at the time, which was a Spätlese, something simple from the supermarket, and that, you know, a German wine and that. And he kind of enjoyed that and thought, oh, you know, let's give him a go here. And he gave me a go on them, watched me some of my beer reviews, got interested, got passionate, and now he's got the bug. And he started brewing, started learning more about brewing, on top of all the kind of, he's got all sorts of doctorate or whatever, he's something or other, you know, passed all sorts of things with chemical stuff and that, you know, all that knowledge of organic chemistry and God knows what else, you know. Don't ask me, it's all above me, you know. But three and a half minutes and I'm still jabbering on. But he's got the bug for brewing good beer. Really appreciating good beer. He's supplying it in his shop and that now, and good beers and good ciders. And he's really got a good palate for him. But he's now brewing his own on a commercial basis. He's got hand in hand with Oates Brewery, Anthony, another good friend and that. Like, both really lovely guys and that. And they've kind of got hand in hand and you know, strange bedfellows as it seems, and there's none stranger. They really have brewed a lovely, lovely beer. The first one I tried, the trial run, I had two trials, and both of them was fantastic. And this is the actual version, the bottled version of the one that I really liked. So I'm going to get me ring. Where's my ring? Oh, it's up here. I'm going to get my little ring from out of the blue. And I'm going to pop the top. Little bottle opener ring. Hopefully it ain't going to kick off. because that was the only thing that was wrong with the first one he had. It was glorious, was the bottle conditioning. And if you look at the video, he ain't hiding nothing. He's kind of like learning as he goes and that. And what's happened? Plain green crown on here that I've just mullered. I do speak posh, don't I? And nice. So put the ring back on. And let's get my little GBBF glass. It's a bit smeary. I think the missus has had this in the dishwasher. But never mind. The old glasses, this is 1985 GBBF. The old glasses tend to gather salt when you put them in dishwashers. And they don't get rid of it. It sinks into them, you know. It won't affect the flavours and things. Trust me, it won't, you know. My bugle's been smelling enough beers. Sorry. Right, let's pour that out. See how we go. It's pouring really beautiful. Pouring very pretty. Golden sunlight. Kind of a sunny evening almost. That sort of thing. And we've got a 330 bottle. I think it's a 330. We're talking 4.8 ABV. Which I think is a drop a little bit in the ABV on the original. But it makes it a more... Go away, cat. I've got my little kitten down here. makes it a more... No, don't you... No, don't. Come here. Hang about. Come here. Come on. My Neil. A little nutty kitten. Gotcha. Come on. There she is, look. She's a crazy loon. Proper crazy loon. How little she is, look. Go on. Shoo off, go on. Get her. Where was I? Yeah. Makes it more sessionable. And his customers were saying, you know, six or whatever it was, the original, is a little bit outside of session beer stuff, and we don't want to be going like, hello, who said that, you know, that sort of thing. So it's give it a little twirl and a smell. Nice kind of carbonation, nice little lily white head. Let's have a little sniff. Lovely little smells in there, really nice little smells, tropical fruit smells. Little aromas and things. Aromas, sorry, not smells. Stinks and all that. Little tropical fruit smells in there. You got a little bit of, what's the ones with little pink seeds? Pomegranate, in it. A little bit of that in there. You got a bit of mango, tiny bit of pineapple as well. Little bit of banana skins almost. Not I've ever tasted banana skins, but the kind of the smell. Where are you going? You'll get run over. I'm on a swivelly seat, yeah? You don't get this on the telly, do you? So, let's have a little smell. What else we got? Hold on. Little hints of cashew nuts in there as well. You got grapey notes. Nice little grape notes in there. They're kind of like those sweet little grapes. A little sweet white sort of. Excuse me. Go away, go on, get out. Go on, get out. Go on. You heard. Interference. Right. Let's have a taste. Because we're now 9 minutes into the review. Let's have a little taste and see what we get. Cheers, everyone. Cheers, Jason. Cheers, Anthony. Let's read the bottle quickly that he's just knocked over. Let's just read the bottle here. Look, I'll give you a little show on the bottle. Do-do-do-do. That's the back of the bottle, by the way. Do-do-do-do-do. And then we got to the front here. Jason and his Argonauts. New World Pale Ale. And look, what's this? Wait a minute. Do 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 ding do ding do ding do ding It says, this is the first batch of a limited edition pale ale from Jason Kotze with the help of his Argonauts. Namely, Anthony Barrett, that's from Oates, Graham Disney and Terry Kay. That's yours truly, me. It's very kind of him to put me on there. But I think a lot of the idea was is I just give a little bit of sprinkle of inspiration maybe or something like that. Poured a bit of passion on it. On him, I should say. Crafted from the purest Pennine Waters and the finest malts including Maris Otter, Pale Ale, and Munich, and what's that? Where are we? Carapils. Carapils, nice, sweet, and that'll give it the evening tinge to it, the colour. And a little bit of sweetness as well, a bit of nuttiness. Available New World hops, including that were married to a wallet bursting amount of New World hops, including Amarillo. That's a little bit of the peachy sort of smell things in there. Columbus Citra, that will be like the mango. And Nelson Sauvin, that's the grapey sort of smell. Named after the Nelson Sauvignon grape and that. So let's taste it. Cheers, everyone. That's beautiful. I'm not going to put that down. I'm going to hold it. That is, I get like a little bit of red tinge on my face as I get passionate. Woo, suddenly everything goes, ears come up on my arm and that, look. Like that. That is lovely. Really, really nice. It was kind of worrying whether the drop in the ABV had taken anything away from it. It's, you can taste there's a difference. You can taste less alcohol. And also alcohol is a big carrier of aromas, so it's not quite so blasting on aromas. That's why alcohol is used in perfumes and stuff like that, as well as, what's it, ambergris and things and whatever else. What am I on about? it also carries flavours as well, you know. Hence, you know, you get flavours, things like alcohols in cooking and things like that. Right, let's have another little taste. I've got to describe this to you now. I'm getting punched with big resins at the moment. Right, first things first, you've got a lovely bitterness. Not a bitterness like a lemon. Not like that bitterness, but a bitterness that hangs on the back of the throat. A bit like a nice grapefruit, like a pink grapefruit. But you've got little edges, hello boy, girl I should say, new one. Little edges of a yellow grapefruit as well in there, kind of like breakfast grapefruit. A little bit of that breakfast juice that you have, orange and grapefruit. A little bit of that going on, but they're kind of the back of the palate, the back of the tongue. On the way in, you've got smoothing that down. You got apricots, you got, let's have another go. You got apricots, but you got a little bit of raspberry as well in there. Little hints of raspberry. Lovely little nutty edges. Little cashew nuts, little walnut edges. Almost like an hazelnut kind of in there as well, that sort of thing. Really nice, that walnut bitter dryness. There's a lovely dry finish. And I always think that a good beer, a really good beer, should walk you hand in hand home from the pub. And this is available in pubs as well, good pubs and that, you know. Pardon me. Nice carbonation, but it's kind of the kind of pumped in carbonation, that, you know, the carbonic-y sort of stuff. No, it's still nice. And I always say it doesn't have to be real ale kind of yeasty carbonation. it can be both. And in a beer that's, I'm finding, like IPAs and fruity beers especially, a bit of kind of, when you've got the smoother, real ale yeasty carbonation, it kind of doesn't produce that punch on the tongue that you need. That electric zap of, you know, lightning. Pew! And you get that with this. You get a nice zap, boom. Zests in there, a little bit of orange zest. Really cute, really lovely. Bit of tea as well in there almost. Kind of little Earl Grey tea. You get slight floral notes. You can taste the flowers, the hop buying flowers, the little kind of round sort of, they look leafy more than anything, but you can taste those in there. And you can almost taste the yellow off your fingers when you've been playing around with the lupulin grains and things like that. Oh, that is really lovely. Well, 16 minutes in, I'm going to finish off with that. That is lovely. As for sessioning, that's difficult. Difficult not to kind of go gulping at that. And I think if you gulp a few down, you're going to start getting that harsh, the kind of hops harshness on the back. But it's still quite gulpable. I think you're going to have to go bottle to go, oh, hold on. But it's really lovely. Really, really lovely. And I could sit there all evening, sessioning them and enjoying them in good company in it. So, talking of good company, look out for the boys. Look out for Anthony. Look out for Oatsy's Brewery. Look out for Jason Kotze and Boffa. And look out for Kotze and Boffa Brewery, you know, with Jason and the Argonauts in it. Fantastic stuff. Brilliant, beautiful. Chin chin. Bottoms up. Nastrovia and Aldo. Cheers. More. Cheerio, chin chin, biddly boo. Where the